Hello friends, I am Professor Shirley Tiwari, and today in this video, we will be talking about resistance to change. So what is resistance? Resistance is the refusal to accept or comply with something. Resistance is defined as a refusal to give in or to something that slows down or prevents something. And when they apply change in an organization, there is a strong resistance that comes from individual or organization level also. So let's see what are these. Causes of resistance to change from the individual perspective. From individual resistance, the first resistance that comes is habit. Most of the time, people feel it's really difficult to change their habit. That is why a resistance from an individual point comes into picture. For example, when an employee is asked to change or move to a new office building across the town, they're likely to change their routine habits like waking up 10 minutes earlier, finding new parking places, adjusting to new office layouts, developing new lunchtime routines, etc. Second comes is security. The team members with a high need for security are likely to resist change because it threatens their feelings of safety. For example, when Indian Railway introduced new online booking for their reservations, employees may have the similar fears. Point number three, economic factors. If the member feels that the new change results in the lower pay, they may likely to resist the change process. For example, changes in jobs or established work routine can also cause an economic fear in people. Next comes is fear of the unknown. For example, the cashier or secretaries might fear the new activities due to lack of knowledge in operating the new software programs. They might fear that it might take away their job. They might fear of the lack of economic growth in them. They might find it difficult to adjust to the new technology. So there is a fear of unknown in people. That is why they resist the change. Next comes a selective information processing relationship. This means that when a team member shape their world through their own way, they prefer to do the work based on their perception. If the change process demands to follow the new method, the members tend to resist. And the last change which happens from the point of view of an individual is our emotions. Emotions play a lot of resistance to change. It can be expected when those influenced are caught in a jam between forces of change and forces of resistance. If a person experiences a pleasant or an unpleasant emotion, there is a chance that the person will react adversely and he will resist to change. So these are certain individual resistance. Now, what are organizational resistance? For example, the first point in an organizational resistance is the structural inertia. Organizations have built-in mechanisms to produce stability. For instance, the training and orientation program reinforce specific role requirement skills. Formalization, providing job description, rules, policies, procedures for the employees to follow. Once the routine has been established, organization is very reluctant to adopt a new change. Number two, that an organization will resist a change is a limited focus of change. This means that a change process is interlinked. One activity cannot be changed without affecting the others. If change is introduced in technology without considering the structural changes, the change technology is not likely to be accepted by organization. Number three is group inertia. Sometimes the group norms or standards could act as a constraint. For example, the union norms may dictate resistance to change process. Next is threat to established power. The change process, which can create a threat to the power or to the senior members of the group, can create a resistance in which the organization will not accept the change amicably. Next comes is threat to established power relationships. Whenever a change happens in an organization, the process can threaten a long-established power relationship within the organization. Due to this reason, the members can resist the change. Next is threat to establish resource allocation. This is the group which enjoys sizable resources, may not like to accept the change process that facilitates reduction in their budget. And the second last is lack of communication. If the change is not explained to the people of the organization or to the organizational board or members nicely, then there'll be a strong resistance against the change. And the last is technology. A technology change are required for the growth of organization. Latest technology, which improves the human skills, must be introduced in an organization. But at the same time, it is very important to consider that no human resource should be replaced by these changes. The moment a new technology comes, the fear associated with that technology also enters an organization. That is why people resist that and an organization resists that. So these are few of the points which are important for you to understand the resistance. Thank you so much.